Hey guys, and welcome back to the Velodicted Channel. In this video, I'm going to show you all of my bikes. It's going to be a little bit longer, so get yourself a cup of tea or a cup of coffee and make yourself comfortable. Enjoy! That's my Peugeot Country 300 commuter bike, complete and fixed installed mudguards, a rear rack and a installed fully street legal light setup with a front hub dynamo, a bell, drop bar handlebars, and flip side pedals, flat pedals on the one side, SPD pedals on the other side. The cable of the rear light is routed internally in the down tube. In the front we have a triple chain ring. In the rear we have a 7-speed cassette. The smallest gear ratio on this bike is a 28 in the front and a 32 in the rear. So nice under gearing for climbing and carrying loads of stuff. As you can see, the conversion here in the front, this originally were Shimano Alto's flat bar shift and brake levers, but I flipped them 90 degrees and now they are vertically orientated as you know it from race bikes. It works quite good. The bike has a quite long wheelbase and it's quite stable on the road. Quick releases all around, front and rear wheel, and also the saddle. The entire bike is equipped with a Shimano Alto's A20 shift and gear setup, and we have cantilever brakes. The bike is intended to be a all-around commuter bike. It's quite heavy, so it's not a lightweight variant, but it's so rugged and I can carry bags with it. In the future maybe I want to add a front rack as well. And yes, it's a great commuter bike, urban bike, bad weather bike, the bike that makes it all. 32 mil tires, you can go off-road as well and handle bad terrain. This was a dead body bike on the road. I saved it from the street. It was in bad shape. I had to maintain it and replace many parts. It was worth because now we have a full functioning bike. The frame was good. Here and there I had to lubricate the bike, but all in all the conversion was successful and I have a great all-around commuter touring bike. That's my Peugeot PH11 and it's a steel frame made from carbolite tubing. This nice red color and a 38 centimeter wide handlebar with this nice silver looking items. The gearing originally was a 52-42 in the front and a 6-speed cock set in the rear with 12-24 heavy gearing. I replaced the whole rear wheel to a modern one, spreaded the frame in the rear to the modern spacing of 130 mm. Now I have a 7-speed cassette, more advanced gearing, 11 as the smallest cog and 28 in the rear as the biggest cog. SKS race blade mudguards or fenders, front and rear, attached to the bike, down tube shifting, non-indexed, but it works perfectly fine. Installed, mismatching tires, Vittoria Corsa, trinkled down from my other road bike, and it's 25 mil front and rear. We have a Sella Italia saddle, SPD SL pedals, old school Weinmann brakes, but modern brake pads from Shimano, and this upgrade is quite good and improves braking performance by far. The size of the frame is 56 and the weight is reasonable. It's quite light, I have to say. Brake levers are updated as well. The routing of the brake cables and housers is underneath the handlebar tape and don't pop out on this point right here. That's quite nice. We had a 6-speed cog set in the rear. It was called a helicomatic hub. Quite rare system, and this was the reason why I changed, because to source stock parts for this is quite expensive, because there are only few out there to this point. This is my second unit road bike, or my winter bike, bad weather bike. It has mudguards, but it's still a very quick road bike. And the second purpose is all around urban bike. Quick bike, very responsive and lightweight. If I want to go from A to B just riding along, I picked this bike because this is quite cool bike. This bike really brought me into road cycling, because way back I searched for a quick bike for commuting, and I don't wanted to have a sluggish bike as I had to this point. And I reached out, and a friend of mine offered me this bike for a reasonable price, and I took it and improved it from day to day. I replaced many parts, and to this point that's what it is. Quite a very quick bike, and I don't regret it buying it back in the days. So thanks to that. That's the latest member of my bike collection. This is the only bike with a flat bar, and this is the Wheeler Atlanta Special Edition. It's a 26-inch retro MTB. I think it looks really nice with all this silver accessories and the blue metallic paint job. 56 mil tires. These aren't really good mountain bike tires, but this have been the cheapest tires I can get with 10 wall, and I think this looks quite neat. Furthermore, gearing, we have a triple chain set in the front and a 7-speed cassette in the rear, and we have plenty of gearing for rough terrain. Additionally, we have cantilever brakes, grip shifters, and regular mountain bike brakes. The framing is from chromoly steel. It's a quite small frame. All the cables are externally routed, so that's quite easy. We have loads of eyelets to install either fenders or racks, front and the rear. That's quite neat. One installed bottle cage, you can install two. Quick releases all around, front and rear wheel, and also the saddle is adjustable. Well, what's the purpose of the bike? It serves more purposes. I always wanted to make a retro mountain bike build a retro mountain bike, and this came in very handy for this purpose. As much as I like to go on a road bike, sometimes I want to go into the woods and off-road. And to this point, I always used my randonneur for this with the 32 mil tires. It basically worked, but I thought maybe I can get a good bike for cheap for this kind of rides. So I found this one, and yeah, for going off-road mountain biking, it's quite cool. Third purpose, maybe I want to go with this on a off-road bikepacking trip. I can imagine that this is a good travel bike, since this has loads of opportunities to mount racks, but also going lightweight bikepacking, I could imagine this is quite good. I can use the flat bar handlebar to attach my handlebar back, and I'm not restricted as on the other drop bar bikes in the on both sides to the drop bar. And also the seat post is quite long, so it's possible to attach here my saddlebag. You can go reasonably fast with this bike, and you can tackle each and every single terrain with that. There are no restrictions due to the big fat tires. This is my latest purchase. I found this bike on eBay for very cheap. It was a no-brainer to buy this for very very little money, and I had to upgrade just a few things. I replaced the saddle, also the tires, because the tires were just very old. Besides that, the bike was in mint condition. This, I imagine, was a bike never been ridden very often, and just being placed in the basement or in the garage collecting dust. And now this bike rolls and rolls, and it's just fun, absolutely fun. Peugeot fixed gear conversion based on a Peugeot Tourmalet road bike frame from the 80s, I guess. As you can see, deep rims from alloy. Everything else is removed, actually. The down tube shifters are removed. Brake levers are removed. I replaced them with those small brake levers on the flat bar section. This is a functioning and in Germany legal fixed gear, because we have two independently functioning brakes, one in the front, one in the rear. This fixie isn't a fixie actually, it's a single speed, because we have a flip-flop hub in the rear, and I have chosen to go with the free hub because I'm not used to ride fixed, and I don't like the idea of having a fixed gear on open roads with traffic and so on. Nice retro paint job and all the decals. This frame is a 62 frame. It's quite big, as you can see here on the seat post, made from chromo steel tubing. The handlebars are 38 centimeters. Gearing here is a 52 in the front and a 18 tooth cock in the rear. Chainrings in the front are still dual, but only one is functioning, and we have 25 millimeter tires installed. The rear cable, rear brake cable, is routed internally through the upper tube. Everything else I removed, like the bottle cage. I think this looks really neat. It's a good riding bike, it's very fast, but you can feel the heavy, deep rims, lots of rotational mass. But since the bike is just for fun and riding around and looking cool, that's the main purpose, that's no problem at all. This bike frame was a gift from my brother, and it was as following. We were traveling to university via a train, and on a train station I saw this frame each and every single day. It was in bad condition, messed up, butt locked, and I really desired the bike, the look, and my brother picked this up, this information, and he made it possible to recover this bike legally. Yeah, and he could remove it with our authorities, and he handed it to me. And from this point, I built it up. Good frame, and I thought, what's the cheapest conversion? And I made a fixed gear out of it, or a single speed. I only had to add the brake levers, the wheel set. I actually could reuse the old chain. All in all, it was a real cheap conversion. And I think this bike is really cool. What do you think? That's my Pro SL 2000. Some people might be familiar with this bike because I started this channel around this bike, and nonetheless, I'm going to present it anyways to you. Rose Pro SL 2000, model 2015. To this point, I've ridden this bike more than 25,000 kilometers, so I have a pretty decent impression of this bike. Aluminium hydroformed frame, 1280 grams, carbon fork, system wheel set of Mavic Axiom, rim brakes front and rear, gearing and braking system is provided by Shimano, and that's the Shimano 105 5800 group set. Bottle cages carbon, gearing is 50-34 in the front, and a 11-speed cassette in the rear with 11-32 gearing. The long cage derailleur, tires are right now mixed. In the front I have a 23mm tire, in the rear a 25mm tire, but normally I ride 25mm on both. The handlebars are 42 in width, and yeah, I changed the one or the other things on this bike, like the cone-shaped headset. I swapped the stem. I re-swapped the saddle. I had a different saddle on this bike, but I'm back on the stock saddle. It's pretty much stock, the bike, except for the stem and the headset. That's my one and only training bike. I use it the year around. If it's raining like crazy, I use my other bike, but this is my main training bike, and I only use it for training, not for going around town. So I track each and every single ride, and I know exactly how the components are worn out. I bought this in 2016, I guess, and it was my second road bike, and it was a big purchase for me. It was back then 1200 euros. It was the replacement of my Peugeot PH11. Modern shifting, modern braking, everything modernized, but actually the same like each and every other road bike. The latest and greatest model of this is a bit different, but all in all it's the same. The entry level 105 group said rim brake version is still 1200 euros. I really appreciate that. Rose did that move and not ditch that model and went totally disc. You are able to buy the disc model, but you're also able to buy this rim brake model, and it's still 1200 euros. That's a great, great move of Rose. Thank you for that. Hey, you're still there. Thanks for watching and sticking around for so long. Maybe you want to subscribe to the channel or leave a comment, or maybe you want to give this video a thumbs up. I really appreciate that. Thanks a lot, and we will see us in another video. Velodicted, cheers.